Hello and welcome to another KublaCubed video tutorial. This tutorial is going to be all about positioning and scaling of site plans in KublaCubed. The most challenging part of defining a site plan is setting its scale and position. This can be difficult because there's no standard way that site drawings are drawn, and so different drawings will have different information on them. The best way to set the position and scale depends upon the information that is shown in the drawing. There are four controls to set the position and scale. Scale, rotate, move, and align to two points. The align to two points button does the same as all the other three controls together. Thus, if you use the align to two points, you do not need to use any of the others. Depending on the situation, you either use these three buttons or the single button. We will start with the three controls at the top and also apply the scale control. The way you scale the site plan depends upon the data you have available. You may have a scale marked like this one, or you may have a known distance in the drawing, like this one here. Either of these can be used to set the scale. So to get started, we click on Scale. First, we will choose by scale and then type in the scale. And then check whether I have scaled correctly by using the measure tool of KublaCubed. So I go to the beginning of my known length, click on the letter M on my keyboard, so I have scaled correctly. Now I will use the other option to scale. I click again on scale, now by length. So I measure my known length. And now to check whether this known length is correct, I go to the My Other Known Length and measure it. So I scaled correctly again. On single page site plans where you are going to do an on-screen takeoff, setting the scale is all you need to do. However, if you're using CAD data, or aligning the site plan to others which are already loaded, you also need to move the site plan into the correct position. In some situations, you may need to rotate it first, although usually the rotation in the loaded site plan will be okay. If the rotation of the loaded site plan is not as you want it, you can use the rotate tool to change the orientation of the plan. You should do this after scaling the plan and before moving it. To rotate the site plan, click Rotate, and you can either rotate by 90 degrees, which is sometimes required for PDFs which are misaligned. Now I will take it back to the first orientation. Or you can rotate to any angle you want by using the North arrow to any angle you wish. After scaling and rotating the site plan, if required, you can move it into position using the Move tool. You can do this either using coordinates which are marked, or using a point which is shared between this site plan and another one which is already loaded. So for example, we can load again page 1. I will scale by scale This time I do not need to rotate. This site plan has coordinates marked on the drawing, so we can select one of the coordinates. I click Move, click here, type in the easting and the northing. Now the site plan is moved into this position, and you can see that also from the value displayed by the cursor. Now we can use the same method to move a second site plan into position against this site plan. So I stop editing. I will load page 2. Again, I will scale by scale. Now you can see that this point on the site plan of page 1 is the same point as this one on the site plan of page 2. So we can click on the point we want to move and then click on its new position. So I click on Move again. This is the point I want to move. And this is its new position. And then, as you can see, the software will move the site plan into the location specified. The final control, aligned to 2 points, does everything in a single operation that the other 3 controls do. However, it can only be used when you have a site plan where you know the true position of 2 of the points. This can be either because you can see them on other site plans that you have already aligned, or because there are at least 2 coordinates marked in the drawing. I will show you now how to use the Align to 2 points button when you have coordinates. So I will load my page 1 again. I will click on Align to 2 points. Choose my first point. Type in the easting. And the northing. And click OK. Now we'll select the second point. Zoom in to be precise. Click here. Type in the easting and the northing. Click OK. Now the software performs all the adjustments necessary to align this drawing to the 2 points you have typed. In this case, the drawing requires no rotation, so it's only scaling and moving of the plan. However, if this drawing was rotated, aligned to 2 points would perform the rotation operation as well. Now we will cover the second use of align to 2 points, where we are aligning to another site plan which is loaded. We will select the second page. So I stop editing. I click on plans, add image, page 2, open. Okay, so now I click on align to 2 points. I select my first point. This is from page 2. And I move it to the same from page 1. And now I try to choose a point that is as far as possible from point 1. It can be this one. So I click here, from page 2, and move it to the same from page 1, that is here, The software performs the same procedure. So now I have my two side plans stitched and aligned together. Stop editing. Thank you for watching. If you have any further questions, please visit our website.